Hello, friends. Thank you for tuning in and joining me. A warm welcome to you. This is David speaking. For the next hour or so, you will hear some piano music with varying influences, whether it be concertos, symphonic works, or pipe organ music. We begin with the Italian Concerto by Johann Sebastian Bach, or what the composer puts it, the Concerto in the Italian style. This work is indeed Italian in both form and style. In form, because we have three movements, the outer movements are faster, they have a joyful, exuberant, and extroverted character about them, and the middle movement sounds very much like an opera aria, lyrical and tender. Stylistically speaking, the harpsichord, on which this piece was first conceived, has usually two manuals or two layers of keyboard. These keyboards can be either played independently, or you can combine the two sounds together to make a rich and full sound, simulating a bigger or smaller string ensemble. Let me explain. This is the opening of the piece. Usually, this is like a very big string ensemble, and in this case, we have the two manuals, or the two layers of keyboard, coupled with each other. And now, let's hear the bottom layer independently. See how the ensemble got smaller? Now, it can get even smaller with the softer and thinner sounding upper layer. Isn't this fascinating? Now let us transfer these illusions to the piano and see how the music can spark your imagination.
Thank you.
That was the Italian Concerto in F Major, BWV 971 by Johann Sebastian Bach, published in 1735. Now let us turn to Franz Schubert and his Sonata in A Minor, D 845. This four-movement work is grand in scale and symphonic and dramatic in character that evokes every human emotion from the heights of joy to the depths of despair. Hope you like it.
Thank you.
That was the Sonata for Piano in A Minor, D845, Opus 42, by Franz Schubert, published in 1825. The final piece on the program is César Franck's Prelude, Chorale, and Fugue, FWV 21, composed in 1884. This piece reminds me of liturgical music played on a pipe organ at church, and, fun fact, there is one section in the chorale which bears notation similar to pipe organ music with three lines in the score. If the prelude can be viewed as fleshly passions and physical desires, the chorale a prayer of forgiveness, comfort, and peace from God above, then the fugue explores everything from pain and agony to joy and celebration, culminating in a bell-pealing B major catharsis. Enjoy. With that, we conclude this solo recital. Thank you so much for listening. I would like to take this moment to express my thanks to a few important people. First of all, to Professor Michael Shertok, who helped me prepare this program from start to finish. Next, to Joel Crawford, who made this live stream possible. Thirdly, to the staff members at the Robert J. Werner Recital Hall for making this recital possible. Lastly, I would like to extend my gratitude to the teachers and professors who have influenced me professionally, to the friends and family who have helped me spiritually and emotionally, and to the kind-hearted individuals and organizations who have supported me financially. You have made me into who I am today. Until we meet again, stay safe and healthy, take care, and God bless.